Hello guys, I'm Yadagir Reddy and welcome to the series of Selenium interview questions. In this video, we will see how we can find the broken links in a website using Selenium WebDriver. So what is a broken link? A broken link is a link on a website that is no longer accessible or that is no longer exist. Okay. So that means, for example, as a customer, you visit one website and you will click on one link. Then you will expect that link to be working, right? Like you will expect that link will open some kind of a web page, right? But instead of that, it is showing some kind of a error codes like 404 or it is saying this site cannot be reached. Okay. So these kind of errors it is showing to you. So those links are called as broken links because those links are not actually showing the proper web pages. They are showing the errors, right? So that is why we call them as a broken link. Okay. So this might be happening because of many reasons actually. So one reason is maybe that page is actually removed from the web application itself. Okay. That means from that website, that page is deleted or it is removed. Okay. And the second reason is maybe the website structure itself modified. Okay. So that means maybe previously the web page is present under one folder like ABC. Okay. So later it is moved to XYZ folder, but they forgot to update the links. Okay. So in that case, it is still pointing to ABC folder only, right? So inside the ABC folder, it is trying to find out the web page, but now the page is actually present under XYZ folder, right? So in these kind of scenarios also, the pages will not be loaded, right? It says 404 page not found. So combinedly, these all are called as broken links. Okay. So in this video, we will see how we can find these broken links using Selenium WebDriver. So now we have discussed about broken link, right? So let me show you how it will be in the real time applications. So here I have an application that is HVR tutorials. So in this application, we have a menu control. So here, if you mouse over on Selenium practice, we have something called broken links. Okay. So this one has a sub menu also. So if you click on any of these links, you can observe the 404 exception. Okay. Now you can see 404 exception. This page is not present. Okay. Or 404 exception. Okay. So like that, I have some other websites also. The world's worst website ever. And we have another thing that is dead link city. So you can use any of these websites for practice today. Okay. So here, if I just click on this Google Maps, you can see error 404 not found, right? So you should not look at this UI actually. This UI might change. So here the UI is like this. Okay. Here the UI is like this. So here you should not focus on the UI. You should focus on the code. Okay. So the error code here 404 and here also 404. So the web page is not displaying, right? So that means this link is not a proper link. It is a broken link. Okay. So in the similar way, we have some other links in this website. See 404. Okay. So you can use any of these websites for the practice. Okay. So now let me open the Eclipse. So here I have created one class file with some code. Okay. So this code will launch the Chrome browser and it will navigate to HVR tutorials website. Okay. So now here I will write the code to test this broken links. Okay. So first we need to understand one thing very clearly. So a broken link is also one link only. Okay. It is not a new HTML control or something. It is also a link only. So that means first of all, we need to get all the links present in that website, right? Then we need to iterate each and every link and we need to verify whether that link is a proper link or a broken link, right? To get all the links, I'm going to write driver.findElements. So here I want to get all the links, not a single link, right? So I will use findElements by. So the best way to get all the links is by using tag name. Okay. Because the link tag name is A. So if you use the tag name as A, it will give you all the links in that web page, right? So here I will say the tag name as A, or you can use the XPath also /A, something like that. So that will also do the same job for you. So now this find elements will return a list of web elements, right? So I need to store this one into some variable. So here I will say list of web elements. So I will name the variable as links. So now I got all the links into this links variable, right? So now what I will do, I'll just print this one size just for the reference, links dot size. Okay. So after this, we are going to iterate through each and every link. So here you can use for loop or for each loop. So I'm going to use for each loop because this is easiest one, right? So from this links list, I'm going to get one link every time. So now we need to understand one more thing. So here, if you observe any link, right? So here, let me take this Google Maps. Okay. So here the link syntax will be like this. Okay. it will be an anchor tag, and you will have something called href attribute. So this href attribute will store the link address where it has to navigate to. So when you click on that link, it will navigate to this website. Okay. So now we need to get this link. Okay. So how we can do that? We have a method called get attribute. Okay. So first I'll store that link into some variable, link URL I will say. Okay. So here I'm not going to use driver dot because I want to find the attribute for this link. So link dot get attribute. So inside this, we need to pass the attribute name. So the attribute name is href. So this will return you the link address that I'm storing into this one. Okay. So here we need to understand one thing. So from the UI, when you click on this link, it is showing this 404 exception, right? So we understand that this is a broken link, but from the automation perspective, how we are going to verify this one? Because you are not going to inspect this element and you will not verify for this 404, right? So here, when you click on any link, it will create a request to the server. Then server will try to identify that web page. Okay. So you are sending one URL to the server, right? So server will try to identify that web page. Then if the web page is found, it will return you the response with the web page. So if the web page is not found, it will send you the response with the error code. So based on the error code, we need to understand whether this is a broken link or it is a proper link. Okay. So now I'm going to do the same thing. So here we got the URL in the form of a text, right? So that means we are storing in the string, but I want to create the URL instance. Okay. URL is a class in the Java. So I want to create that instance URL, new URL. So here I need to pass this one, this text link URL. So now the URL instance is created. Okay. Then we need to open the connection to that server. So I will say URL dot open connection. So now once you open the connection, it will return you one object. So URL connection object, it will return you. So now I need to store that URL connection. So now in the web applications, we usually have two types of request, right? HTTP and HTTPS, right? So for this one, we have one class, HTTP URL connection. And in the similar way, for this one also, we have some class. So you can use any class to send the request to the server. So now we have only opened the connection, but we want to send the request, right? So for that, I need to create the HTTP URL connection object. Okay. So this HTTP URL connection is an abstract class. If you just go into this one, you can see this is an abstract class. So that means you cannot create an instance to this one, right? You can pass this one. I mean, you can assign this one to this instance. Okay. So let me do this. So here I'm assigning like this. Then it will ask me to cast. So I will provide the casting. So now this URL connection is converted into HTTP URL connection object. So using this one, we can send the request. So I'll say connect. Okay. So this will send the request to the server. So before this, I'll recommend you to use some kind of a timeout. Why? Because sometimes it will get some timeout exceptions. Okay. So when you're connecting, right, because of our internet speed or something, if it is taking more time than the expected time, then we will get the timeout exception. So I'll suggest you to use some kind of a timeout here. So how do we set the timeout? Set connection timeout. So here the argument is int timeout. So it is not a seconds. Okay. It is a millisecond. So if you mouse over on this, so here you can see sets a specified timeout value in milliseconds. So that means if I want to give 5 seconds, I need to provide 5000, right? 5000 milliseconds is 5 seconds. So now we sent the request to the server, right? So then server will try to identify the web page, then it will send you the response, right? So that response also will be present under this HTTP URL connection only. So here I need to verify that server response. I'm going to put a if condition here. So HTTP connection dot get response code. So we have a method called get response code. If you go into this one, it says if it is 200, that means it is a valid URL. So other than 200, it is an invalid URL. So here for 404, it is unauthorized. Like that, we have so many codes. Okay. So if you go to this dead link city, here you can see all the error codes, 400, 401, 402. So like that, we have so many error codes. So other than 200, anything else is a broken link only. So now I will put a condition to verify 200. So it is giving the response code, right? So I'm verifying whether it is a 200 or not. So that means I'm verifying whether it is a valid URL or not. So if it is a valid URL, I'll print something like this in the console. So I will say link URL. Then I will print the status code also, this get response code. So it is just for the user purpose, I mean to identify. Okay, I will give again some space like this, and I will print the response message. So here we have some response messages also, http connection dot get response message. So now this will print the code, I mean, so here obviously it is 200, right? Okay, so let me copy this. So for the else condition, I will add this code. Okay, so here if it is not 200, that means it is an invalid URL, right? There is a broken link. So I'm going to use sys.error. So here I'm just printing in the red color so that we can see easily. So here I'm going to remove the response code from the positive one, because in the positive section, I don't need the response code, right? I know that response code is 200 already. So after this, here we have connected, right? I mean, we sent the request to that one, right? So we need to disconnect the connection also. Okay, so HTTP URL connection dot disconnect. So now let me execute this program. So here the web page is opened. So once all the URLs are printed in the console, the web page will be closed automatically. Okay. So now the web page is closed, right? So that means verification is completed. So here you can see these three are printed in the red color, right? That means it is an invalid URL or maybe something else. Here it is saying moved permanently. So if you open this web page, so here it is opening, right? But if you look at this one, it is moved to HTTPS. Okay, so if I just copy this URL, so it moved to HTTPS. Okay, but in my application, it is referring to HTTP. So that is why it is saying moved permanently. So further, 301 is the code, error code. Okay, so if you again come to forward, okay, so here we got the broken links, right? 404. So whatever I have intentionally put, those links are printed here, right? So now we are actually verifying it in the correct way only, but it is very difficult to scroll again in the console and identify which one is a valid and which one is an invalid one, right? So to make it easier, what you can do, you can create one list, okay? You can create one list or set, and you can add all these invalid URLs into that one, and you can print only that one. So here you no need to print this valid one, right? So we know that already it is a proper link, so there is no point of printing this one. So that is why we are going to just modify this code. So here I will create one set string. So here I'm using set because I don't want to store the duplicate URLs also, okay? Because while I'm printing, it will print the duplicate again. So that is why I'm using set here, broken link URLs. Okay, so I'll just instantiate this. You can create any set here. So let me just copy this. So here I'll just modify this code. Okay, so inside this if condition, I'll write something like this. So instead of this 200, I will say not equal. So if it is not 200, I wanted to add to this one dot add, and I want to add this link URL to this one. And after the program completion, even after this driver closing, I will print all these URLs. So if I print them, so let me run the program again. So this is not a much difference, guys, okay? But it will actually print you in a proper way. So you don't want all the URLs to be printed in the console, right? So this time it will print only the invalid URLs. That means the broken links only in the console. So when the browser is closed, we need to understand that the verification process is completed, okay? So now the process is completed, okay? So here you can see it printed only the broken links, okay? So this time I am not printing all the links, I am just printing only the broken links, and manually I can just go and verify whether this is working correctly or not, what is the issue and all. Then I can report it to the developer, right? So this process is very easy. So that is how we find the broken links, okay? So here I want to tell you one more thing, okay? So that is very important. So basically when you do this one at home, it will not throw you any errors. Why? Because you will not have any proxy related issues. Okay. But when you are running the script in the companies, right, in service based companies or something, where you will have some kind of a proxy, right? So in that case, it will not execute because it will try to connect to that URL, but because of proxy, it will not able to connect. Okay. Then it will say all the URLs are invalid only. So for that, you can add the proxy here. Okay. So how you can add? So after creating this string URL, right? So you can create a proxy instance, proxy, new proxy. Okay, so here, let me just import the proxy reference. So it is coming from java.net package. Okay, not the other one. So here proxy, we need to select the type. Okay, for type also you need to select this proxy java.net.proxy dot. The type is HTTP or SOX or anything. Okay, so usually it will be HTTP, right? Then here we need to pass the socket address. That means your host name and port number. Every proxy will have some kind of a host name and port number, right? So that we need to create here. Inet socket address. So here you can see we have inet address or we have host name and port. So you can use this one. So here you can give the host name. Okay, now I'm giving this random one. And port will be like 8080 or 443 or something. So now the proxy instance is created, right? So where do we use this proxy? At the time of URL connection. Okay, so here we are actually opening the URL, right? So if you just pass this proxy into this one, then you are good to go. So you can execute this script behind the proxy also. Even though the proxy is set up in your applications, I mean in your company, you can still verify the broken links. Okay. So this is how we find the broken links using Selenium WebDriver. Okay. So if you have any proxy related issues, you can use this proxy. Okay. So if you don't have any proxy related issues, you can remove the proxy and use the normal program. Okay. So I will upload this program into my GitHub URL. My GitHub repo is this one, yadagiriddi/hvrtutorials. So in this one, you can find one folder, Selenium interview questions. So into this one, this program 3. Okay. So this is a program 3. So I will upload this one into this one. I will leave the link also in the description box below. So this GitHub URL link and this practice websites links also I will leave. Okay. So that is for this video, guys. If you have any doubts or if you are facing any issues, please let me know in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.